authoritative source when mentioned by name. Excuse me. So effectively, this is a brand question. Google say they don't look at brands, but this feels like it's a brand question. And if you go back and look at lots of the sites that have been affected by Panda, they're all sites that have historically done very well at SEO, but not especially well at brand building. I think if you were to go out into the street and ask 100 people, do they know Review Center, do they know TripAdvisor, I think I know which one most people would know. So just to recap, the actions we took, we rolled out a new site, we blocked a whole load of weak pages, we removed a lot of duplicate content. 3 months on from that, we've seen no return from Panda. We ran with reduced AdSense for 2 months, again, no impact, and we're now looking at consolidating content. So one of the other 23 questions is, it asks whether you as a website have got lots of overlapping articles on the same content. So we're now looking at bringing overlapping articles into single pages on Review Center. If anyone wants to download this presentation afterwards, I've included some of what I think are the best pieces of Panda journalism on the web. Thank you very much.
Some really interesting data there and a really interesting time for user-generated content and sites. I don't, if anyone's got any particular questions, can they put their hands up, but I'm, because I've got the microphone, I'm going to speak in the first one, because that's how it works. Given the aggressive advertising theory, do you think there was a kind of level of hypocrisy there from Google that you had one team in there recommending that you should be doing more of this? Because that's what the AdSense team were recommending at that point.
Yeah, without a doubt. So our AdSense contact was always telling us to put more AdSense, put higher up. Massive hypocrisy.
Who's next on the question? Anyone with any hands up? Oh.
Hi, are you looking to undertake any activity to kind of strengthen your brand? Is that something that you're looking to? I recognise that's hard and expensive.
Yeah, that's extremely hard. And I think this is one of the issues with Panda, is that so Google have taken actions to reduce traffic and therefore revenue to a site, and therefore it makes it a lot harder for us to do these activities that might actually get us out of Panda. So at the moment, it's not something we're strictly looking at doing.
Anyone else? Okay, I'm coming in that direction. I'd like to sing a song under this for Indiana Jones. Dun, 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 dun. Dun, 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 dun. Okay, where were you? Here we go. Pass it along.
Sorry, yeah, does this make you think that in the future it's quite dangerous to rely on Google rankings for a large part of your business? And what would you do to kind of, would you diversify?
Yes, certainly. Well, it's something we were trying to do even before Panda. It certainly makes things like your social strategy much more important. Yeah, without a doubt. It's something we're putting much more focus on now post Panda, trying to do.
Time for one more, anybody? Oh, two. Okay, time for two more.
Chuck along here.
Given what you said about brand terms, do you think there's a measurement with regards to the ratio of brand terms to non-brand terms in terms of maybe anchor text? In terms of
are you saying it's to do with the volume of or the kind of links that are coming into your site?
Yeah.
No, that's a really interesting question. Review Center are quite unlike any other site that I've ever worked on. People seem to love linking to either reviews. Or to their writing pages, and I'd say that we've got one of the most diverse link profiles I've ever seen on any website I've ever had to look at. So I don't think that would be the case.
And Tony.
Hi there, Johnny. I work for a big brand, but we equally saw some pretty heavy hits from Panda.
Yeah.
And whacking. I just wondered on your sort of timings on like post Panda, you've done some changes, 4 weeks to make the site changes, was it 6 weeks to recrawl?
Yeah, I think that's an optimistic figure, to be honest.
Yeah, I was just wondering, did that flux, did that change post-Panda, like the frequency of Google recrawling?
No, it's not something that I've noticed. I haven't noticed some crawling quicker. Certainly, we found it really difficult to get changes indexed. So, especially when we took off all our duplicate content, I think it was actually even a lot longer than 6 weeks for people to come and crawl that.
Yeah, it's exactly what we've seen as well. So I just wondered if that's part of Panda potentially.
I don't know. But we actually started using, you know, the new tool in Google Webmaster Tools, it fetches Googlebot, and then you can then submit that URL into Google's index. So we actually started trying to use that. Trying to get through this content machine.
Well, fantastic. Can we just have a round of applause for Johnny there?